Hey, what's up, man? We got the homie Lantana here with us today at 411 Uncut. What's going on?
Man, you already motherfucking know, man. I woke up today. I'm free, man. It's beautiful, man. I'm here with Nella D, the wonderful Nella D and shit, man.
Man, yeah. I'm so glad to have you. It's been a while. I remember when I first started my podcast, you were probably like episode 2, 3. You was one of the first people I interviewed. So first things first, you're from Cincinnati, Ohio. Cincinnati since my mama had mm-hmm. me, as you say. You're from College Hill, correct?
Yeah.
Talk to me. What was it like for you growing up in College Hill?
You know, shit, College Hill. I mean, the regular shit, you feel me? The regular shit, man. Hood shit, you feel me? It was cool. I got a lot of family there and a lot of friends. But just like, man, what I was talking to you before we came on this camera, though, it's just the same shit. I'm just thinking about this shit, like the trauma that niggas be having and shit like that, man. I don't really want to get into that off the rip, but I be wanting y'all to understand, like, man, just talk when we start talking about hoods, it's really the same everywhere you go, for real. Everywhere you go, when you dealing with like economic classes and shit, when you grow up in a certain type of range, man, it's like the same shit that somebody would go through in the crevices of California, they'll go through that same shit in Ohio. You feel me? It's just different type of ways, but everybody, like, you know what I mean? It's regular shit, for real.
Nah, for sure. And I get a lot of people that say that. They say, you know what? It's like the same as, you know,
every other
hood.
Same nigga shit. Niggas dying, niggas selling dope. Bitches, niggas, that shit so motherfucking. That shit, I was telling my nigga earlier, like, man, you could look at pictures from the 80s and looking at how they was young niggas then. It's the damn near the Paid in Full movie rerun over and over and over and over.
Man.
You feel me? Like, the hood, man, be regular shit, man. Not a lot of people dealing with traumas that they don't ever deal with. You feel me? Like, niggas having dead friends and having people that they know go to jail for years and years and years, like, what the fuck, like, and then you just alive and you living like this is the life, but that's really like a lot of fucking trauma, you feel me, that niggas be dealing with. Even if you say you a nigga around the corner from you got killed, you ain't even know him, y'all ain't niggas or nothing, but you knew him since he didn't grow up his whole life. And now he get killed, you feel me? Just be...
It's weird.
It's weird as fuck. Yeah. It's weird as fuck, man.
Oh, yeah. So, what led to All Hustle No Luck?
Man, shit, just, man, because that's how I was really, like, you know, before I went to jail, it was already our slogan, you feel me? I had a record label with my nigga Doughboy and Bono. It was called Grind Capital, and the slogan was All Hustle No Luck.
Yeah.
And then, you feel me, when I went to jail, it just made more sense. Like, that's when I started really thinking about the shit. Like, it was my first tattoos on me. Like, yeah, it is. We can't depend on no lucky shit. I used to get in certain shit and I blame God. I'd be like, man, what the fuck am I doing like that? Like, man, that's when I realized, like, we can't depend on nothing. But what we do and everything that we do is really on us. You feel me? Like, it ain't nobody's fault that you do whatever the fuck you did. You feel me? You might got reasons, but it's still on you. And then it's just like, you know what I mean? Luck, we ain't gonna depend on it. Like, if we could get lucky and something happened to us, that's what's up. But if not, fuck it.
Man. And too, with I Hustle No Luck, I mean, during that time, it was such a big deal because you had the support from the entire city, but you was the first artist that we seen utilize Facebook, social media to their advantage and know how to promote. What did you know what you were doing at the time, or it was just
hell?
Like,
nah, you know I did. I didn't even peep. Like, it was still MySpace when I went to jail. Right. I didn't have a Facebook. You remember? I used to be in the club with a fucking a real camera. Like, a real camera taking pictures. That's fucking so how old I am, motherfucker. In the club with a fucking camera. Yeah. Like, I didn't have no iPhone. iPhones might not have been out yet.
No, they was out.
Yeah, but I didn't have none. I ain't had none of that shit, you feel me?
But the ground was there.
The ground was there because it was like, all right, this how it is. And I was dolo a lot of the time, like, just doing that shit. Because
you was taking pictures with every single
body.
Yeah,
because, man, it's really like, I'm blessed with that personality where I could fuck with people and talk to people and disarm them. Like, man, it's love. Like, it's all good. You can fuck with me. I'm not no hoe in no type of form or fashion, but you can fuck with me.
Word.
You feel me? Like, it's some authentic shit. And if you don't, that's okay too.
Did you think doing that was gonna lead you to?
Yeah, I knew I was hard, man. I had like a lot of confidence in myself. You feel me? Like, it wasn't like I ain't had no big cheerleading squad with that shit. It was certain people that was there from the very start and loved me with that shit. But I just had confidence. Like, man, like, fuck you.
Word.
Fuck you. I don't care. I'm going to get there.
Man.
Like, it's like a something that you, that's why I can know when I come and run into certain people and I know, like, if they got some type of art or something they going into that ain't normal, I could just tell because it's like a certain amount of, like, I'm going to make fucking get there.
Man.
You feel
me? It's only one way and it's mm-hmm. just to win. You're not thinking about nothing else.
Yeah, like, I can know myself when I'm bullshitting, like, man, you ain't having that feeling right now. Mm-hmm. Not having it. You need to get that feeling in you. You feel that feeling, like, no matter what, anything, nothing. I don't care about nothing. I'm not nothing but succeed.
And I mean, it really got you to the biggest level ever. Now, would you ever think that you would want to be a signed artist again? Or
If it make perfect sense, I ain't been, look, man, they motherfuckers be tweaking on me about this fucking record deal so bad, right? I'm like, look, the only thing they ever did was like the All Hustle No Luck remix and shit. Like, everything else was on me. In the beginning, it was me and Dan Gotti. I never had none of that shit behind me. Like, I really rather just do this shit how I do it. Because I can't have nobody talking to me and telling me shit, for real. I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. And it just ain't who I am, who I am. Like, if somebody come in and it's like a big bag and just let me do what I want to do, and we can figure that out, then we can figure that out if it makes sense. But other than that, I don't. Man, I'm doing this shit out of love. I'll take care of my son and my family and we good. All that one shit. But I can do this shit for the pure love of it. I'm really better rapping than I ever was, for real. If motherfucker listen to my music now, from now to then, I'm really way better with all of that shit. I do it because I love it, and it's just like,
it ain't about a record deal. It ain't about a record
deal. It ain't about no fucking record deal. And I never really was no, like, tweaking about no fame at all either. That's why I act like that. Motherfucker's like, bro, you need to, maybe, but I'm just a humble nigga. I'm cool. I like people.
Yeah.
You know, I like people. I like to see happy people. I like to see people make it. I like to see people get rich. I like to see people see a nigga get the bitch he always wanted. Man. I'm happy for it. So-